we chose Willy Wonka last year when we were in the middle of Music Man. We try to be like a year ahead of where we're at, mm-hmm. so that we can plan for our personal lives. Like, don't make any plans next spring because we're going to do this. But we knew we wanted to do another kids show for a variety of reasons. Obviously, there's a lot of ticket sales, but kids shows are just fun.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, you get 30 Oompa Loompas up there and everybody has a good time.
Secret to being an Oompa Loompa?
Go with the crowd.
Terrific and awesome, and you need to hug an Oompa Loompa because it brings you luck.
Staging a show like this, I mean, I don't even think I would have looked a second time at Willy Wonka, because a chocolate river flowing across the stage at Crescent Elk.
Takes a lot of, not to be campy, but it takes a lot of imagination mm-hmm, for a mm-hmm. show like this because it's all fantasy. Mm-hmm. I only started really getting into set design probably 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. And 2 or 3 years ago, and Joan Bueller has been our primary set designer, and she's kind of looking to take a step back, so she pulled me into it. And it's fun. It's a lot to think about.
Yeah.
And so you have to remember certain directors want certain things, and you have to sit down with them and say, what I like to do is sit down with the director. If I'm not directing and I'm doing just the set design like I was for Nutcrackers, mm-hmm. I say, okay, give me 3 minutes on each scene. Give me your 3-minute vision on what you think the sets would look like for each scene in the show,
mm-hmm.
and then we'll sketch it out and kind of go from there and see if it's what you like mm-hmm. or what you don't like. For the ones I'm directing and doing set design, it's a little easier.
Yeah.
Sometimes we have to remember that while we would like to have these big grandiose sets, we also got to fit 30 people on the stage. So you have to kind of, and I like to design a set to leave a lot to the imagination. I mean, obviously this one, Chocolate Rivers, and the backdrop that's up there now and things like that are pretty self-explanatory. But, there's some sets that are pretty minimal, and as long as they're done right, that's okay.
Yeah.
So, like this show, we had a great turnout for construction and painting. We had, over the 4-day weekend, we kind of were here every day doing it, and we had, I think, we had anywhere from 15 to 20 people building and painting mm-hmm. at a time. And so as soon as something was built, we'd slap it up there, throw some base coat on it. We were not above holding a hairdryer to it to get it to dry so we can paint it and get it done.
So how does the two-director thing happen with you and Marshall?
It works out really well. I think we complement each other pretty well. Mm-hmm. He's sort of the big picture, the overall vision guy. I tend to be the logistical detail guy. Like, mm-hmm. we have to make sure we have X, Y, and Z in place before that happens. So I think we complement each other pretty well. This is our fourth show we've done.
Oh, wow, okay.
So, we kind of have a system down, and, once you get into that groove, we just run with it. Mm-hmm. So it's really fun.
This is one of those shows that is going to be incredibly heavy in set. If you had a chance to read the script, it kind of follows the first movie a lot, but it's going to have to really rely on lighting, on your energy, and a lot of creativity. So I'm willing to accept creativity. If you have a thought, write it down, bring it to Joey or myself. I'm open to creativity the month of January. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1.
Chocolate squiggles and chocolate giggles. chocolate whirlies, chocolate swirlies, chocolate twirlies for all you girlies. Chocolate bagels or chocolate bugles or chocolate puffles or chocolate troubles will grow and grow and grow. The day that he retires, we know.
How many shows does this make for you, about, with LRT as a director?
Directing, for, I think, about 12.
Okay. And what are the challenges with a cast this size and a production like this, you know, staging on this stage?
Every show has its own challenges, and this particular one was really heavy on set, so we have a lot of little short scenes, so it was a challenge getting all the different pieces of the set put together, but it came together like it always does. The large cast, it's typical. I enjoy working with large casts. So.
Ready, guys? Ready, here. 2, 3, and no more giggles, no more swirlies, no more swirlies, no more. Stop, do that again. 2, 3, 4. No more giggles, no more swirlies, no more twirlies, no more bugles. Does that rhyme so well?
Yeah, it does.
Okay, kids, say that with me. We're just really enunciate it. We're just going to say it. Ready? No more giggles, no more. See that breath coming from down here? And?
Gum.
What you eating, Julie?
Pixie sticks and gum.
Frankfurt, Germany, where Wonkamania has suffered over 2,000 bars.
And there are shows that we would love to do, but we just don't get the men to try out, you know, that could do those parts. So we kind of have to think realistically about what we know, you know, the known quantities. And, you know, sometimes we get a surprise, you know, like Michael's doing Willy Wonka was a surprise, and he's doing a great job.
First came the snow. Huge flakes came drifting down slowly from the steel blue sky. Then came the wind. Inside the shack, chicks are freezing in.
I'm just wondering how
can we start
limber you are.
I'm limber.
Okay, so you know that hit where Gene Wilder did the
tumble?
Yeah.
What am I gonna be falling on? I think I can probably work it out.
He'll be the stage floor, but...
And yeah, he's had a really cool
one. He's so into this.
Nice hat.
That's why.
That. I thought it was perfect.
It's real now.
Hey, you're the man.
Yeah. No, yeah.
You alright?
Feel a little bit of... I won't bother the audience with my malady.
How do you get into the head of a character like Willy Wonka?
You don't. I grew up, obviously I read the Willy Wonka, the Charlie and the Chocolate Factory book, and I think a lot about Gene Wilder. And I kind of had to take a different... If I could have my druthers, I'd do it just like Gene Wilder does in the movie, but... this play is a little bit different. It's a little more clear in this play that Willy Wonka is kind of making all this happen. He's kind of behind everyone who gets the golden ticket. He knows how it's supposed to end. And so that's kind of my motivation, if you go by it. I'm a little more sinister. I'm trying to play the character like I know how it's going to end, but I have to deal with all these little kids in the factory. I just got to get through it until I can finally give the factory to Charlie. I don't know if that helps, but... You know, Gene Wilder, I would say, is kind of my inspiration. But, you know, yeah, I guess I kind of think a lot of Gene Wilder.
There's the sinister side to Willy Wonka.
There definitely is. It's a dark side, I would say. That doesn't even come out in the Gene Wilder version so much, but it's definitely in the book, and it's in this play as well. And so I kind of savor that a bit, too.
You do your lines very, very well. Your delivery's good. Do you ever ad-lib up there? Do you ever do it?
Yeah, there's a couple lines in there I've kind of thrown in there. That Marshall hasn't stopped me yet. So, like, there's a scene, I think, with Mike TV where I talk about, picture yourself at home, you're sitting down, you're watching TV, and I say, shouldn't be too much trouble, and I kind of rub his head. And so that's kind of an ad-lib line, which has now kind of become, I guess, part of the script. But
what about the, that was all theater line? Is that in the script?
That's in the script.
That's in the...
It doesn't say to pause, and I just kind of savor and look at the audience.
Yeah, because it looks like an ad-lib when you do so. That was very
I'll
cool.
take the credit, but it's not, no.
Okay, so for with a production like Willy Wonka, how do you start with costuming? What's the first thing you do?
Well, a lot of times we watch a video when we get the script and go through it and get their ideas about what costumes should look
Who
like.
Who supplies the video? Is it a video?
Sorry,
is it a video from whom?
Now I don't know if Jeannie Allard got a video or Willy Wonka or not, and she's the one that got the script. Mm-hmm. She does a lot of the figuring out what the costumes are going to look like, and so we just have a big plan first. Got to have a big plan, and then we kind of build, you know, what the main characters are supposed to look like, how they're supposed to dress.
And is it something you sit around and discuss and brainstorm?
We brainstorm, yeah. She and I have been doing it together for several years of the brainstorming, and then we have to get patterns, figure out patterns for everything, and fabric for everything. And we go to Medford armed with every Joann's coupon that we can find, and she goes to Reading, and she's really good on the internet too. So
I want to be clear for everybody here who comes and sees a show like this, or even another one that reminds, all of these are made. I mean, these are
and she and I usually cut out everything, and we have spent now last year we spent several days. All we did was cut out all day, and then. We usually put it in packages of this costume. We got 20 of them, so we have 20 packs. Make up the directions, and then we try to find people that we can give all this out to.
Oh, to sew?
To sew.
How many people does it take to put a production like this together?
You know, we don't have as many this year. We sometimes have about 10 people that we can, you know, give things out to.
So
sew.
Tonight, in an orderly fashion, we're going to hand out your costume. When you get your costume, this is what you're going to have. You're going to have a hanger, that hat.
So, Chase, tell me about the hat.
Yeah. The hat? What hat?
The hat you're wearing.
the people gave it to me, and I put it on.
What people?
The costume people.
Who are the costume people?
The costume people.
Will you mind pointing them out for us? Oh, you just did, sorry.
All right, so how's it going being Augustus Gloop? I talked to you when we first started doing this, like, months ago.
Well, it's going pretty good. Yesterday I was falling apart, and today my costume got left other places. And but, you know, that's just typical 12-year-old. but, yeah, it's going great.
How many shows have you been in now?
Oh, I don't know. At least five. This is going to be my sixth, I think.
Wow. I remember you in The Wizard of Oz. Was that your first?
Yes.
I wasn't really thinking about the character, but then I thought, the only real German that I know is Hans and Franz from Saturday Night Live. So I just went up there and I thought, what would a female Hans and Franz do? And they would say something like, I want to pump you up. And I did it like a chick would say it.
How many productions does this make for you, LRT production?
10.
Seriously, 10? What was your first?
First was Wizard of Oz.
What were you in The Wizard of Oz?
I was one of the Hollycock Guild.
The hardest thing about being Charlie Bucket?
Trying to act poor and... Yeah.
And then, what do you like about doing this? 10 productions is a lot. You must like it. What is it you like about it?
What I like about it is that, like, how just, like, acting and being on stage where I'm being noticed instead of being, like, at school where nobody notices me.
Hi! I'm Jolie. I play the part of Veruca Salt, as you already know. Ew!
I never had gin shine. Never had a song to sing. Suddenly after the world, I'm an amazing thing. I've got a golden ticket.
You got that?
Tell me how you get into the character.
Okay. Veruca. So, how I get into my character is I think of, like, a bunch of mean people that I don't like, and then I think of how I get to, like, scream and stuff, and then I think of everybody else in the play, and how I just get to be brought to them for this one time. That's how I get into
it. Trout reported that sweet is rapidly turning sour. With nuts! Don't forget the nuts! Apparently, you can't have chocolate without the nuts these days. Good luck, Veronica.
It's Veruca. Veruca.
Mr. Mike TV. Wait, hold on. All right, Mr. Mike TV, how do you get into the character? How do you put yourself in the right space?
Well, I play video games.
Now, is it? Huh?
And then I'm in there.
So is that true to life? Do you play video games? Really? No? What do you do for fun instead of video games?
I ride my bike.
Some kids like electric trains, and some kids like to use their brakes to earn a university degree. I don't share the truth for knowledge. I ain't gonna go to
school. Really? I don't serve. Do you think anyone sees that? I. Look, 400 people here. You guys say I. You can't go I. Nothing can be small. And transitions, you can't stop. Okay, now it's time for me to go to this. No, they have to be smooth. So the first thing, down the electric train, and sometimes they like to use their brakes to earn a university degree.
Some kids go to baseball games, other kids have useless things like 10 days at a Boy Scout jamboree.
Hey, Kevin.
Kids read books and learn.
Behind it.
Get into the head of Miss TV.
Well, I thought a lot about it, and I think she's someone who overprotects her kid, and that's why she gives him all the media to, distract him from dangerous things that could be outside or something like that. So
that's an interesting motivation.
I think she's overprotective. I think she may be a little OCD. So
I gotta put my socks up.
Yeah. Do you have the the suit on as well? Is that ready to go?
Nope.
Oh,
I'm
second.
I'm free.
Oh, cause second act.
Yeah.
Only take your pants off.
Oh, you're funny. Yeah, and it gets funnier every time. Yeah.
That gum is so fun. It's delicious. It really tastes like pea soup. Oh, and here comes the roast beef. So tender and juicy.
And the blueberry ice cream.
I'll bet it's to die.
That's what I'm afraid of, the blue dye.
Violet, you're so busted. Texas is gonna do
lights
it.
Down.
Candy
be blue.
Down the drain.
I told her not to chew it.
Too late, really nothing to it. Cause I know just how to chew it. There's no need to poo-poo it. All I have to do is do it.
Violet, it's so bad for you. Violet, you're turning blue. Violet, what you gonna do? Just stand there singing in my blue. Yes, she's turning blue. It's true, oh Violet.
You look like you're from the Bowery there with the hat, man.
Oh, God, don't remind me about the hat. It's so small.
So tell me what it's like being Mr. Bucket.
It's a great honor, I suppose.
Is this your first production?
This is my first LRT production. Yeah, I did plays in high school, but I'm far out of high school now. So it's been about 11 years since I did a play.
You get back into it, all right?
Yeah, I don't know. I was really nervous at first, but it's pretty natural. I mean, I'm on.
Do you need a rip-up ticket and a regular ticket? So act two is the rip-up ticket, and act one is the regular ticket.
Yeah. Okay. Isn't it funny how you can clear a room?
No, people come running. Tell me about wrangling these props. Are you in charge of props just across the board? And
yes,
I understand
sir.
You made this food.
I did. I made it from, not insulation foam, but the foam that you patch cracks with. And because it's really light and it's really durable, and some of the dancers and things need to move around. So it's good for stage. And if you notice, they're bigger than life because it has to be seen from far away and big and colorful.
How long did it take you to make this?
About... Four days, a few hours a day, along with some other props.
Good job.
Thank you.
There's a lot of equipment maintenance that goes into this. And once we get the show going, it's just a matter of running from memory and watching the show. Otherwise, the hardest part really is all of the prep work prior to.
How many mics are you running with this with the crew?
Currently, I have 20 mics on stage. I've got 14 wireless, 2 hanging, and 2 floor mics.
Really confusing.
It's a real challenge to get them all to talk to each other. Or not to.
So any insights into being Grandpa Joe?
Well, I'm eminently qualified for the part. I'm definitely a grandfather. In fact, I'm a great-grandfather. And not to mention the fact that I'm also 80 years old. Which may have something to do with missing my cues. But anyway.
Come on, Dad. Have a piece. You deserve something special after losing your job.
What?
It's Phineas Trout. Here we are. How soon to opening night?
Well, we got about a week till opening night, and honestly, I'm feeling quite confident in my line.
All right, so tell me, Jules Bailey, what do you like about being in a production like this?
The dancing. Yeah, that's fun.
That's the best part. You can take a rainbow, wrap it in a song.
Choreographer faced with a cast this varied in talent and age and
all that's things. Definitely the biggest challenge is that they're so varied. I mean, I have 32 Oompa-Loompas, and that's a little chaotic. Trying to get them all on the same foot at the same time is definitely challenging. But they actually memorize things better than a lot of the older crowds, so it's pretty impressive. And then I have some of the other dances have, I don't even know, 10 years old to 46 years old. So that's a pretty big variance there. So, and a lot of them have had some dance training, some of them have had none. And it's really hard to come up with a movement that everybody can do and make look halfway decent.
Settings for all these dimmers. This show is actually pretty simple as far as shows go, because it's really only about 4 different sets total. And then I also have a computer which is controlling like the footlights down there, mm-hmm. and each one of these is just it just is a clip. And it's really nice to have the computer because it's actually doing all of our color. Everything else is basically one color, and then what it controls is like those polka dots that you see running around. It's controlling those, it's controlling all the color for, like when they go to outside and it's supposed to be blue, that's what they're doing. Then I have a false spot operator here, Lori, and then I have Ken on the other side.
There's no knowing where we're going. There's no earth where there's no soul. To the south, we're going to the north.
your destination's shown. So it's all a bit bizarre.
Phineas, I need an update.
Well, it appears to be the day where everyone has the heebie-jeebies, and everyone is feeling a little antsy. I'm getting a little frisky. I have no idea why, but it seems that it is production night, the opening night. So apparently we have a full house. I've yet to be seen, so I cannot confirm nor deny this. And I am claiming diplomatic immunity if anyone says otherwise.
All right, so. Now do it as Christopher Walken.
What, that whole sentence? Or everything else? Because we have a whole house of everything happening now. I'm playing the piano, so I'm gonna leave. Bye.
Been through this before.
Yes, I have.
What is it? What is the difference then now tonight when you get up there and you step out in front of an audience?
I think the biggest part is the amount of energy the audience provides to you. It's unbelievable how much energy you get from them. It's really fantastic. That's what the whole reason you do it.
Thank you.
No problem.
How's it going so far?
Very nice. So you ready?
As ready as I'm going to be. I wasn't nervous until I saw the triplicate and then got here and saw everybody. So first time I've been nervous.
Any words of advice, Dutch?
Huh?
Any words of advice, Grandpa Joe?
Yes, bring food.
He knows what he's talking about.
Thoughts.
We're ready to go. We have a show. I'm excited. Let's do it.
Rituals, anything you do before a show?
Breathe. And pace.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Any last minute things you do to prepare?
Not really.
Yeah? We'll break a leg.
Hopefully not.
I think about something.
Hey guys, 2.5 months we've been working on this, and now it's time to have fun. Okay? A play goes like this. I'm going to break just for a second. A play goes like this. It starts with a lot of energy here, and I've already explained this, and then it goes down a little bit because it gets hard, and it gets tough, and the last 2 weeks have been tough. We're tired, we're cranky, we're having to do over and over again, put in a lot of extra hours, and I really, really appreciate what you guys have done. This is a collaborative process. It's not just me, it's not just you, it's everybody. Every single person involved in this production has got to do their part and did their part. And that's why it's going to be as good as it's going to be, because you guys have put in the effort. It's really exciting. Opening night is exciting. We have a huge house out there, and they deserve a great show. Now, there are a few things about a big show. One, you got to be louder. You got to be louder than you ever have been, because they are going to suck it up like a sponge. It's been an open house, and you've been able to hear your voice coming back at you. It's not going to come back at you. It's going to get absorbed. So be aware of that. Also, another thing that happens, and laugh lines. You're going to get people laughing. So when that happens, you wait a little bit, the laugh will go up, and then as it starts to go down is when you come back in. Okay? Exits and entrances, the quicker, if you even act like you're going a little bit faster, it just makes the show just more energetic. If people are kind of sluggishly walking off, then it slows everything down. I'm not worried about that, because you guys got a lot of energy tonight. I can tell. This last hour, you guys got a lot of
Come on, Christy, give me your best.
Thank you. simply look around and view it.